listen to reason. Will you open your eyes and surrender what you'll find with an open mind? You may be.
Welcome to Atheist Experience Live. I'm your host, Matt Delaney, joining me this week, Martin Wagner. Welcome back. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine. I'm all right.
We got Sean in New Jersey. How are you?
Hey there, guys. Good evening.
How you doing?
All right. First off, I've got an observation of mine, which I kind of find kind of interesting, which will lead into a question for you.
Okay.
I find it kind of funny and ironic that a lot of fundamentalist creationist Christians who deny evolution almost basically have to profess that they're all fallen sinners, that they're these base and filthy creatures that deserve eternal punishment in hell. But as soon as you say that they're descended from primates, you know, don't you call me a monkey?
Yeah.
that's way too much of an insult for
yeah.
me, you know? So
yeah.
Say that I deserve to go to hell, say that I'm a dirty sinner, But don't say that we share a common ancestor with apes. That's just going too far.
Yes, it's one of life's many little ironies that you encounter.
But going into that, as far as Christianity's concept of sinners and what we deserve and how low we all are, I was wondering if you think that might point towards, you know, a non-human authorship. If you know, if religion and Christianity is really just a human construct, then why would we portray ourselves as so low and so worthy of you know, of damnation, so filthy? Wouldn't we build ourselves up as great?
No.
Mm.
Because that doesn't benefit the religion. Building individuals up as great benefits the individual. Tearing individuals down and saying that the religion is what can save you, that's what benefits the religion.
Mm. Well, so then does that... A lot of people always say that, you know, a big function of religion is to show exhibit control over lower, you know, over people who believe it. You know, it's a great way for kings to rule over people, and it's a great way to control people.
Yeah, but it doesn't control people in like the George Orwell 1984 sense. You know, it doesn't do it overtly. It does it through this careful sort of manipulation of a person's own attitudes, right? Mm-hmm. Makes them do the work, right? You know, what Christianity does through all of this talk about sin and original sin and how fallen we are, but don't worry because God loves you and he sent Jesus, etc., etc., etc. This is all about tearing down the self-esteem of the individual in order to reconstruct it in such a way that the religion is now at the center of that self-esteem.
Yeah, extreme fundamentalist Christians in particular, but fundamentalists who have this type of view, they are the battered wives of religion. They are the, oh, he really loves me, I'm just not, oh, that was my fault, I'm just good enough. And what this does is it benefits the institution or individual that's in control by, you know, tearing down and belittling the other individual.
Mm-hmm.
And I guess it's just battered spouses and not battered wives, because evidently
yeah.
there's some guys in that position too.
Yeah, somewhere, yeah. Well, I guess what my question then is, well, then why was it like that to begin with? You know, I mean, you say, well, it benefits the religion, but you know, man created the religion.
Mm-hmm.
So why wouldn't, from the very beginning, man just be using it as a, you know, instead of a tool to break himself down, to only then build himself up, to just build himself up in the first place? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because...
Well, religion,
I can't.
I'm sorry, I was just going to say, because the Christian faith took many centuries to evolve into what it is right now. I mean, you know, when you, hundreds and hundreds of years, and throughout this entire process, you began to get, you know, it went from just, you know, I guess if we want to go ahead and take for the sake of argument that all this stuff happened, you know, it went from Jesus and his disciples all the way up to now a very big church with its own politics, and then getting and then all of this comes into play, and then suddenly there are armies that the church supports, and it becomes a big political movement, and this all takes time to develop. So it something could start out being entirely benign and then get corrupted and then turn into something really horrible that's completely contrary to what it used to be. I mean, I saw an editorial cartoon some years ago, back when all of the televangelism money scandals were happening with the, was it Jim Baker, Jimmy Swaggart, and you know, this, that, the other, right?
His was sex.
Yeah. Well, it was sex, money, just corruption. Yeah. And what actually what happened was, I think Falwell's group was going to take over Baker's when Baker ended up going to jail. And then Falwell came out and said, oh, I'm disgusted by all this. And you know, and so I saw an editorial cartoon at the time that was basically all of these, you know, fat men in business suits, you know, in a big corporate setting, said Godco on the wall. And, you know, and they're all looking at spreadsheets and charts and graphs and what have you, and, you know, and on the phones, and there's 20 of them. And then, you know, in this corner of the room, like Jesus looking all meek with his little shepherd staff walks in. You know, and you know, one of the guys yells at him, says, how the hell did you get in here, right? I mean, it's a sort of, so something could, yeah, so something could start out and be entirely benign and then just, you know, and then it takes on a political life of its own and becomes bad.
Well,
and then,
especially if someone...
And then so if there's dogma involved, then that really makes the political reality of it just even more hardcore. It's just, yeah. So...
Okay. Well, that's a very interesting insight. I appreciate it. And just real quickly, you guys, I wasn't going to bring it up, mentioned it, the Christian side hug, I couldn't help but notice. And I was wondering if you guys thought that was real.
Yes.
Well, there's one real and one that was a parody of the real Christian side hug,
the original thing was real.
Mm-hmm. Well, I guess the practice of Christian side hugging, but I assume that you were referring to the
original
kind of
rap song was real at a youth event for a real church.
Yeah.
Well, that's what I thought might have been the case at first also, but afterwards I saw what I thought were some legitimate interviews. Now, maybe it wasn't, I wasn't sure, which were saying how it was parody, that it was actually kind of Christians maybe poking fun a little bit at themselves for some kind of...
Okay, then they're just as bad at that as they are at discerning reality. I've seen plenty of parodies of their side hug that were side-splittingly funny, mm-hmm. But the first one, you know, it did not have the ring of parody. And you don't get up at a megachurch as part of a series of songs and messages for your youth group and say something that you don't mean.
Okay, all right. Well, that's certainly a valid opinion. I would encourage you, though, to at least check it out online.
And, yeah, and if I've been duped and it was never legit, I definitely would like to know.
Well, I wouldn't say you were duped because, I mean, I think you, of all people, certainly wouldn't put it past some fundamentalist organizations to have a song like that.
They did it. If they're going to then claim that it's parody, quite frankly, I'm more likely to believe that their claim that it was parody has come because they finally were shown how stupid it was.
Yeah, well, that's the other thing that I was thinking.
You know, it's like when you say something, somebody goes, "What the hell's wrong with you?" Hey, man, I was just joking.
CYA.
That's what I think is more likely than.
That's certainly very possible.
Mm. Right. Yeah.
Well, I guess
in either case, it's funny. I mean, it's funny, period. That's what matters.
Regardless. All right, well, I know there are a lot of calls after me, so I appreciate you guys taking the time.
Sure. Thanks Sean. Appreciate it.
And Christian
side hugs.
And Christian side hugs. Yeah!